I am Dr. Hadi Dhamasher, and in today's lecture, we will discuss why we study the course on linear circuit analysis in the electrical engineering course. So before we begin, electrical engineering is actually a very interesting and an exciting profession for everyone who is interested in the applied role of science and mathematics. Electrical engineers have played, you know, a dominant role in the development of systems over the past 150 years, and they have truly revolutionized how people live and they work. Satellite communication links, for instance, the telephones, the television, the media industry, the digital computers that we have, the gadgets that we use to enhance the standards of the today's life, and the surgical and the medical equipment, assembly line robots, the energy storage devices, and the electrical power tools. These are some of the representative EE or the electrical engineering products in the modern world. So, for instance, let us see this particular satellite that I am showing here. So as you can see, this is a very, you know, a catchy field, a very interesting field that has made this whole world a global village. So how these satellites are powered up? We, in this electrical circuit course, we deal with such problems where we study how the power and energy can be supplied and how the elements actually interact with the supplied power and the energy. So as you begin to study this course on circuit analysis, you will see that this particular field of electrical engineering, or this particular subject of electrical engineering, you need to get a sense that where this important knowledge of this course fits in the electrical, you know, engineering. So an electrical circuit is basically an interconnection of electrical elements that are modeled mathematically. By mathematical modeling, I mean that the terminal information of the elements that are interconnected in the form of a circuit, we have information about their voltage and the current and the power they consume. So this way we can actually have an idea about how we can solve a given electrical circuits. So electrical circuits are used from the generation of electrical power, how they are generated, whether the generation is in terms of the thermal power plants or in the form of the coal power plants. We have offshore wind turbines that are harnessing the wind energy into an electrical energy, or whether we use solar photovoltaic panels to harvest the incident solar light into an electrical energy. So the electrical circuit knowledge is essential in understanding how a power is generated, number one. Number two, how we then transmit this power to the cities if the plant is located in a remote area, and then how it is distributed among the end users, and about how end users actually utilize this electrical energy, what kind of loads they are using, what is the impact of different type of loads on the power carrying capacity of the transmission lines, and how we can actually protect them against the failures that may arise due to abnormalities in any device or any protection system. We use this knowledge of electrical circuits for all of these things, but this is not even limited to this particular device thing. From the perspective of information sciences, the use of and the knowledge of linear circuit analysis is pivotal in understanding the process of coding and encoding information, storage and retrieval, and subsequent signal processing. So you may ask that electrical engineering ranges from the power generation, it goes all the way to the signal processing, it is involved in the medical equipment, it is involved in the future transportation systems, we use it in the defense industry. So you may ask that we have such a broader field of electrical engineering. So what is the common ground, or what is the point of common coupling among all these fields? So The answer is this particular course, which is the linear circuit analysis course. So the electrical engineers in particular, they use the knowledge of linear circuit analysis to solve the problems that are linked with the to the modern society. So LCA is, which linear circuit analysis is about how the analysis and design of electrical circuits are inseparably tangled with the ability of the engineer to design complex electronic communication, computer, and the end consumer products. So with this all in this mind, circuit analysis is actually not fundamental to the entire breadth of the electrical and computer engineering. Rather, it actually stretches well beyond these predefined boundaries. As such, civil engineers are required to undertake a course on electrical circuits so that they may know how an electrical wiring takes place in a building environment, and how in a integrated project, in mega projects, how we integrate all these things. So as such, the knowledge of linear circuit analysis provides and fulfill the prerequisites and learning advanced courses, and also to become a practicing engineer. Also, the models that we use in understanding this particular course, the mathematical techniques that we study, the associated laws and the theorems, that is the language of the circuit theory, they form a framework for your future engineering endeavors, whether you would like to go into the satellite communication, you want to design the antennas, you want to go into the field of information sciences, you want to design new applications for biomedical sensors. You need to understand how an electrical system works, and that is what we actually teach in this particular course on circuit analysis. So for these reasons, it is the starting point for all the future engineers who wish to work in this particular field. You have to have strong foundations in this particular subject so that you can participate in the ongoing advancement in the modern society by improving and refining the existing systems, and by discovering and developing new systems to meet the challenges, the ever-growing challenges of this growing society. So I hope that the series on linear circuit analysis will provide you a very good understanding, and it will create an interest within yourself for electrical engineering. And in the meanwhile, like we did for the power electronics, we will, inshallah, we will do the simulations, and we will learn how an electrical circuit is analyzed mathematically and how it is validated through the computer-aided simulations. So stay tuned. Take care. Thank you very much.